Today's video is about a disease that occurs exclusively in males. It is about prostate cancer. You may be watching us today to help a husband, a brother, a father, or yourself who has been diagnosed with this disease. So let's start from the very beginning. Hello everyone, I'm Ume. And before we start, please subscribe to our channel so next time you will be updated with our new releases. What is prostate? The prostate is a walnut-sized gland that is part of the male productive system, located just below the bladder and in front of the rectum, surrounding the urethra. Its secretions make up a part of the semen that nourishes and transports sperms. As men age, they usually experience an enlargement of the prostate. This increase in size causes the urethra to narrow and subsequently decreases urine flow. This condition is known as benign prostatic hyperplasia and is not the same as prostatic cancer. So what is prostatic cancer exactly? When we say the term cancer, we generally mean uncontrollable abnormal division and growth of a specific body part. Therefore, prostate cancer is the uncontrollable growth that starts in the prostate gland. Prostate cancer is one of the most common types of cancer. It is the second most frequent cancer diagnosis made in men and the fifth leading cause of death worldwide. The difference may now be clear between prostate cancer and benign prostatic hyperplasia. Whereas in benign hyperplasia or growths, they rarely turn into malignant, they don't invade tissues around them, and they don't spread to other body parts, and they can be removed. While in cancerous growths, it is a threat to life sometimes. It may spread to other body parts, it can invade nearby healthy tissues, and often can be removed, but it may grow back again. Our role today is to answer most of your questions regarding prostate cancer. Today, we have Dr. Park, who is a leading doctor in Hanyang University Hospital. He is going to discuss with us about prostate cancer from an experienced medical point of view.
Hello, I am Sing-yong Ryo Park, working in the Department of Urology. Among the urology departments, many tumors are treated, and in addition, prostate disease and urolithiasis are treated. Yes, nice to meet you.
So the first question will be about prostate cancer. Can you please tell us what is prostate cancer and what's usually the symptoms of prostate cancer?
We've all heard of prostate before, but there are many people who don't know exactly what it is. Women don't have them, only men have a prostate. When we make a baby, semen comes out and the pockets that store semen are connected, and the prostate serves as a channel through which semen is ejaculated to make a baby. So in a way, it's a reproductive organ, an organ needed to make babies. But only men have a prostate. When the urine flows out of the urethra, the prostate wraps around it. So if there is a disease here, you may have difficulty urinating and there may be symptoms. There are many different diseases in the prostate, but the common one is enlarged prostate, which causes the prostate to enlarge. This is more common than prostate cancer. Although prostate cancer is less common than enlarged prostate, just like other cancers, it progresses quickly and has a huge effect on the human body. You asked about symptoms earlier, but in the early stages, a lot of cancers have no symptoms at all. So all you can do is have regular health checkups to see whether you have cancer or not. And when you feel you're at risk, you should be examined in advance to diagnose the cancer early. When you have symptoms already, for most cancers, you would have already passed stage 3, meaning the cancer has progressed. Like so, prostate cancer has no symptoms at the beginning, but when it is progressed to a certain extent, the symptoms can be very similar to that of an enlarged prostate, such as the need to urinate frequently, thin urine. But otherwise, pain and also hematuria, and when the cancer progresses further, unlike other cancers, prostate cancer transmits to the bone. Once it is transmitted to the bone, it can cause pain in your bones. So there are cases where people go to the orthopedics due to bone pain. but then end up being diagnosed with prostate cancer. Therefore, it is very difficult to tell with just the symptoms. To summarize, just like other cancers, prostate cancer has no symptoms at the beginning. However, even if there are symptoms, there may be only symptoms that make urinating uncomfortable. And if it gets a little worse, you may bleed or have pain. Or in severe cases, your bones may hurt. That's how we can summarize it.
So, for the diagnosis of prostate cancer, what kind of examinations can we do?
Actually, if the diagnosis is very complicated and difficult, it is difficult to diagnose the disease. But prostate cancer is very characteristic and can be suspected at first by simply doing a blood test. Therefore, a blood test figure is characteristically elevated in prostate cancer. Even if you don't have any symptoms, whether you have a regular health checkup or there are many prostate cancers in your family, the first thing you should do is a prostate blood test. There is a specific antigen of the prostate called the PSA, which rises when it is cancer. If that goes up, you should first suspect prostate cancer. In addition, a lump may be seen on the ultrasound that simply uses the anus to see the prostate. Another more accurate way is to make an MRI to see the inside of the prostate in great detail. But fundamentally, to confirm that there is no cancer, we usually do a biopsy. The biopsy is not by wounding the stomach, but by stabbing the prostate like this with a needle through the anus to obtain several tissues. If cancer comes out, the final diagnosis is made for cancer.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the levels of prostate cancer?
All other cancers are similar, but prostate cancer is generally divided into stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, and stage 4, just like gastric cancer and liver cancer. However, until stage 1 and stage 2, it is expressed as early cancer because it is still in the prostate. From stage 3, it has progressed slightly further out from the prostate. In this case, since the cancer has only progressed a little, we would do a combination of surgery and additional radiation treatment, or surgery and additional drug treatment. Stage 4 is the highest, right? Stage 4 means it has eventually ended up spreading far out. So the disease is not only in the prostate, but the whole body as the cancer has spread in different parts of the body. In this case, rather than surgery or radiation therapy that only treats that one place, it is done through some kind of injection or medicine to treat the whole body, such as chemotherapy or other treatment for the whole body. So the levels of prostate cancer are also divided into 1, 2, 3, and 4.
So after the surgery, does it come back again, the prostate cancer?
Prostate cancer, of course, has good treatment results after surgery. Because of the initial treatment, there are many cases where cancer has not developed for a long time. Cancer can progress from bad habits such as eating too much meat or smoking. But just because the surgery is done, that doesn't mean it's finished. After the surgery, you have to change the bad habits from before. But just because the surgery is done, people stop caring about that and stop looking after themselves, and that can always bring the cancer back. But the probability of getting cancer again, as I said earlier, in terms of stage 1, stage 2, and stage 3, the higher the number, the higher the probability. Although stages 1 and 2 are very safe, they can still happen again, even after 10 years.
How about heredity? Does it play a role in prostate cancer? For example, if somebody in your family or you have family history of prostate cancer?
Heredity?
Yes. Does it help in you getting prostate cancer?
In general, prostate cancer is said to increase from age 60 or older, whether Asian or Western. If you have a prostate patient in your family, especially if you have a prostate cancer among your cousins, close family members, father's siblings, or any brothers, if one of them has prostate cancer, you would have a bigger chance of having prostate cancer up to 3 or 4 times than the average person. And if there are 2 people in the family with cancer, your chances go up to 10 times. So it is said that it increases a lot from our 60s. But if you have prostate cancer in your family, you should actually start checking it from your 30s, because it can occur at a much younger age. So prostate cancer is very common. In Western countries, it is the first place among male cancers. It is also ranked the fourth in Korea. So if any of the men in your family had cancer, they must start testing for cancer when they reach the age of 30. Even if there are no symptoms, it's one of the cancers with a lot of genetic factors.
So as a doctor, can you give any suggestions to prevent prostate cancer?
The cause of cancer is the same for all cancers, not just prostate. But there are risks that we have from birth. It's said to be a genetic factor, but it can't be changed by any effort. You can't change parents, right? Second is lifestyle, and then food. But this lifestyle and food can be changed through our efforts. Fat is the most representative of prostate cancer. It does not say that we should not eat meat, but animal fat, for example, beef with a lot of fat. So it doesn't matter if you eat meat. But if you eat too much of the fat side, it is said that there is a risk of prostate cancer. Chuck is rich in fat, but tenderloin beef has less fat. And if possible, especially if you are overweight, it is very important to avoid such food. But you can eat fish or meat with less fat. Otherwise, if you are overweight, you can lose weight and, if possible, eat vegetable-oriented food rather than meat. Like other cancers, it is very important to maintain balance in our body through moderate exercise and calorie consumption. As you know well, alcohol and cigarettes are in many ways bad for our health, and it's also fatal for cancer. There are foods well known for preventing prostate cancer. I said earlier that there are many cases of prostate cancer in the West, European countries. But there is a country that is an exception. Italy has very low rates of prostate cancer. Why? It's because they eat a lot of tomatoes in that country. There is a red ingredient called lycopene in tomatoes. Eating a lot of lycopene can especially help prevent prostate cancer, so there is even a nutrition made with that ingredient. When eating tomatoes, rather than just putting them raw in a salad, it is better to boil or cook them in oil, just like Italian food, so that the ingredients can be absorbed much better. So eating tomatoes is especially good for prostate cancer. And in the East, we eat a lot of beans. This soybean contains a lot of ingredients that have various anti-cancer effects, such as isoflavones. So eating a lot of beans prevents various cancers, especially prostate cancer. Then green tea. It is also said to be good for cancer because it has great antioxidant activity and is said to be effective for prostate cancer.
According to Dr. Park's interview, while many have heard of the prostate, many do not know its role. Now, the prostate's key role is in reproduction by providing secretions that make up a part of the semen that nourishes and transports sperms. The most common illness of the gland is benign prostatic hyperplasia, which is the enlargement of the gland. However, prostate cancer is a common cancer that affects many men. In the early stages, there are few or no symptoms. Thus, early detection is key, as many arrive for help when the cancer stage is in the late stages. There are many serious side effects as it progresses. For example, blood in the urine or semen, as well as bone pain as the cancer expands to the bones. The diagnostic for prostate cancer is quite simple. Just with a blood test for PSA, we can ascertain the possible presence of cancer. If that is positive, we can also go for additional tests such as MRI and biopsy to make sure we are dealing with cancer. Now, prostate cancers can be divided into four stages. If you catch it in early stages of one or two, typically the localized treatment can be successful. If treated early, the likelihood of recurrence is low, but can still happen if the patient reverts to his old habits. If one has a family history of prostate cancer, early checkups, even in his 30s, is key for preventing the disease. In order to prevent the disease, it is important to limit the intake of fat, especially with meat. He recommends eating fewer fatty cuts of meat or fish. Also, in Italy, prostate cancer is low due to the intake of tomatoes, which is high in lycopene. In Asia, many consume beans, which is high in isoflavones, and green tea, which is high in antioxidants. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Cloud Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave below and we will respond to you as soon as we can.